Tonight, the search continues for the hit-and-run driver who critically injured a University of Minnesota graduate student in August. Kyle Wong suffered a traumatic brain injury. Today, Charmaine Nero talked to his family. She joins us now with more.
That's right, Lauren. Kyle's family says while he has shown signs of progress, right now he's still in a coma. Now they're hoping to get him to specialized care facility in Colorado as he continues his fight to live.
We're both U of M alumni, and he's definitely a diehard Gopher fan, diehard Minnesota Vikings fan.
Pictures show 22-year-old Kyle Wong back in May at his graduation from the University of Minnesota's College of Biological Sciences.
His dream was to be, you know, one day a science journalist.
A longtime goal he worked to fulfill, but just 2 days before the start of a new career back on August 20th, Kyle was left severely injured from a hit-and-run crash in Savage, just 5 miles away from his home.
Kyle is at HCMC. He's been there since the day of the accident. He is in a coma still.
According to Minnesota State Patrol, a driver in a Dodge Ram 1500 traveling westbound ran a red light on Egan Drive at Highway 13, hitting the driver's side of Kyle's car. The driver and occupants left the scene before officers arrived, and Kyle was taken to the hospital.
We don't know what the prognosis is going to be. We don't know what the future is. It's very unknown, which is hard to not have answers.
The family says Kyle was on his way to a specialized rehabilitation facility in Colorado, but to their disappointment, the insurance company denied their request.
We want Kyle to get the best care possible, and for that, that is going to be a specialized facility that treats TBI patients.
While they're hoping to raise enough money to get Kyle the care he needs.
We just miss Kyle.
They're staying by his side.
Talking to Kyle by his bedside, praying for him. For him to wake up.
Hoping the people responsible are caught soon.
Just help us bring a little bit of closure, just a little bit of closure to what we are dealing with.
Now, if you have any information, call State Patrol as they work to identify the driver involved in this crash. So far, the family's GoFundMe has raised close to $117,000 to help with expenses. We've included more information at care11.com. Back to you.
Yeah, it's all so sad. Charmaine, thank you.